I am Gunther von Schumann, employed by the Namibia Scientific Society in the library. And in addition, I'm a founder member of the Museums Association of Namibia. As we are working close together with all museums in Namibia, we promote also the libraries in the museums countrywide. Charles John Anderson is not only for me, but also for Namibia in general, I think a very important Swedish pioneer. He was the one who created the first substantial extended map of Namibia and stretching into Botswana and present-day Zambia. And interesting is that on his map also he indicated the presently called Victoria Falls. John Anderson traveled extensively through Namibia, Botswana, and the later so-called Rhodesia. And as far as we know from historical researchers, Anderson definitely marked the Victoria Falls or indicated them before Livingstone. The Swedes strongly represented amongst the European populations in Namibia. In fact, until 1890, it is reckoned from statistics that the Swedish population were the largest in Namibia. And that is also documented in the way of many diaries which have been published by hunters from Sweden and also people who came to research on our small animals like beetles and birds. And here one can also mention the largest bird collection in existence is housed in Vänersborg in Sweden. And to that whole collection, Anderson, Ericsson, Captain Ian, and various other Swedes contributed largely. Anderson, first of all, if we look at the very early publications, his travels, which he published four different books. And then, of course, he is also remembered in many towns where we had the Anderson Street. Furthermore, Anderson also traveled extensively in the Atosha Pan, and this is why he is honored with Anderson Gate, for instance. And Anderson also studied animals, and not only that he was a hunter, but gave us descriptions of various areas where we don't find animals which he still observed in those areas, especially in the north. What I as librarian appreciate a lot is that Anderson assisted not only travelers and miners, but also the missionaries. And he took them along also up to the north into Ovamboland and assisted them where they started, like missionary Hugo Hahn, to translate the indigenous languages into a European language and vice versa. And this is why we have got today various old, first initially published, so to say, reference works on the indigenous languages, comparing it with European. Well, the highlight of Anderson, I would personally reckon, are his maps of the country. As far as he traveled, he was an outstanding cartograph and compiling his routes through the country. and named places which are, some of them are also forgotten today, where the indigenous people originally had their cattle and trading posts. For many people, because of assisting them, the indigenous people, they saw him as somebody standing out above all the other locals. And this is why one finds references where they talk about King Anderson. What also is important, that Ericsson and Anderson really made a great impact in Namibia by establishing the trading stores in Otjimbingwe and Umaruru, for instance, which assisted not only the pioneers and travelers from Europe, but also the locals were able to purchase all the necessaries they also needed, especially during the dry seasons. Otjimbingwe was a Herero and Damara settlement and was situated at the Swakop River, and because of the water the people settled there originally. And the travelers coming up from the coast followed the Swakop River because of the water for their trek oxen. And this is why people started to open up trading store and developed it as a trading center. And it became also the headquarters of the Walvis Bay Mining Company, who had stationed their workers in Otjimbingwe and mined the copper at the Matchless Mine. And from Otjimbingwe, ox wagon trains were then sent down to the coast with the copper, and freight trading goods were brought up again with the ox wagon. Because he was appointed manager of the Matchless Mine, he bought some of the old missionary society buildings, established his living quarters and his trading store at Otjimbingwe. And secondly, he developed the ox wagon transport system for the mine from Otjimbingwe. Otjimbingwe, unfortunately, has virtually died as a thriving little local town, because the traders moved to Karibu, and Karibu took actually over as the central town in that whole area. And today only a few remains of the old buildings are still visible. Anderson's book, Notes on the Birds of Damara Land, is one of the few old published books on bird life in Namibia. And what's particularly interesting is that he mentions birds in areas where they don't be living today or are seen today anymore. And there are a variety of bird species which he documented right up to the Cunene and Okavango rivers, which are also found in southern Angola and in some cases in Botswana and further south in South Africa. But it's one of the most sought after books from the older period on ornithology.